Well, back with the leading group in the marathon, just gone past 8 kilometres. And as you can see, one or two changes. Field's bunched up.
Well, the whole field's come together now, and I've just been checking the times. I got a time through 7 kilometres, which when I worked it out, I found out why Greta Weitz had let the leading group go, was because they did the first 6 or 7 kilometres in averaging under 2:20 pace, which is world record pace. So I was thinking that Greta had let the leaders, let the stars go, but actually Greta had been doing it much more sensibly, and she'd been looking at her watch all the time and checking the time, and now the whole lot have come together. And there's Rosa Mota shouting to the side of the road, what time are we doing? She hasn't got a watch on herself. And that first 7 or 8 kilometres was a little confusing because one group went away and the other now have caught them. So the whole field is coming together and they're all in that leading group.
Wouldn't you say, Brent, that that was unusual for someone of Rosa Mota's experience not to know what sort of time she was running? Because, I mean, in front of her, the time clocks are out and she must have people put around the course. And with her experience, it's slightly unusual and rather dangerous to go off that fast this early.
Well, they're a funny breed, the marathon runners. They don't trust the official clocks. They usually wear their own wristwatches. And I just noticed there that she hasn't got a wristwatch on. Her coach is obviously on the side of the course because she's been looking around a few times for him. And I saw him, she shouted across to him there and she pointed to her wrist, what time are we doing? So it was a little confusing. Lisa Martin was obviously stretching along a little bit too quickly. And now Greta Weitz, who's joined the leading group, has got there more conservatively and has burned up less energy. So, you know, the thing's coming her way.
I wouldn't just say it was unusual. I think it's incredible. Because it's all about pace, judgment, and your judgment's helped if you've got a watch on. Having said that, though, the timing clock is usually on the lead car, and they've always got a full view of it. And each kilometre is marked on the roadside. And also, there are stewards out there with kilometre markings held high as well. So, really, I would have thought Rosa Mota must know, surely, what she's doing.
Well, the only thing that I can possibly think is the fact that they went through the 8 kilometres and they actually worked out what time they were on, then they found out they were travelling faster than 2:20 pace, and they immediately slowed down because there's no way that they could have been caught in such a short time unless they'd made that sort of decision.
A couple of the Chinese girls up there. Zhao Yufeng, number 111. Also up there is Zhang Yuandi. There's Susan Tooby of Great Britain in the second group, and with her is Kathy O'Brien of the United States. Susan Tooby, one of the Cardiff twins, her sister runs in the 10,000 metres. Susan's now 27. She was the first Briton home in the London Marathon with a time of 2:32:09. But half a kilometre behind the leaders. And in that leading group now there are about 15.
Lots of pleasant shade on that route. Notice the trees all the way along. I think this has been very carefully chosen because it's the temperature's certainly booming up in the stadium. This is a bowl, of course, and it's rising in here, and it's a relief to think that those women out there have got quite a lot of shade. In fact, it looks shadier where they are, even in the middle of the road and away from the trees. There are no big shadows there, although we're in sunshine.
Talking about Rosa Mota, you know, she had a little bit of a troubled time coming into the Olympic Games because when the Portuguese team was selected for the Olympics, she wasn't included in the team because she'd refused to run for Portugal in the World Road Race Championships in December of 87 after she'd been world champion. And they said, right, if you don't do that, we're not going to pick you. So she said, well, I'm not doing it, and they didn't pick her. And eventually the decision had to be taken up to the Minister of Sport, who said Rosa Mota has the best chance of winning a gold medal for Portugal, and you might have politics in your sport of athletics in Portugal, but the Portuguese nation want to see Rosa Mota, the world champion, go out to Seoul, Korea, and represent our interests, and that's why she's here. Now she's totally fallen out with the athletics officials, but she's here to do her business.
Showing for the first time there, the New Zealand athlete, fifth in 1984, Lorraine Moller. Moller wearing 4:41. Also up with the leaders, I noticed one of the Italians, Scuratolo, wearing 3:52.
And Lorraine Moller, of course, must be regarded as one of the key people in this race. tall girl at 5'8½. She's 33 now. She's the winner at Osaka in both 86 and 87. Osaka in Japan being one of the key marathons that people regard as a traditional one, of which you can look at for a form. And she was the winner of the Boston, another of the great marathons, in 82 and 84. A silver medalist in the Commonwealth Games in Edinburgh, plus a fifth place in the 3,000 metres. And if you link that together with a fifth place in the 84 Olympic Games in Los Angeles, then Lorraine Moller, of course, has all the credentials to do well here. Tall Lorraine Moller from New Zealand, who wears 4.41.
5.49 in the centre of the shot. Smeknova, perhaps the best of the Soviet athletes. And in fact, it looks as if they've missed the 10,000 metre time there, because they're in that area. However, we've got no control, obviously, over the distance clocks, distance measurements, which seem to be on the screen at the wrong times. The important timing points from our point of view, 5,000, 10,000 and every 5,000 metres. But Brendan Foster's trying hard to work out the pace, but I think they're through 10,000, Brendan.
Well, that's a very important time check, both of the athletes and ourselves here, to find out exactly what pace they're running at here. And I'm struggling to find out that time, David.
Actually, I've just recognised that area. I don't think they have got to 10,000. If you remember it, I think it's by the bus terminal. Do you remember the bus terminal with all the long-distance vehicles? Buses go to Busan and Incheon and various places like that. I think they're still short of 10,000.
Well, I remember the bus area, but I can't see the 10-kilometre mark. Anyway, Lorraine Müller, Greta Weitz, Rosa Moder and Katrin Dörre of East Germany, they must have slowed down, because the group wouldn't be as large as it is here, and Lorraine Müller wouldn't be running at 2.20 pace, because she's not that kind of athlete. She's not that good to run 2.20, but she's good enough to judge her pace. And I think that her and Greta Weitz have judged the early part of this race quite sensibly, quite conservatively, and I think that might actually pay benefits in the later stages.
You may have noticed too, about 1 kilometre back, the shadows were out there and the sun was blazing down, but there is a bit of cloud cover, and at the moment you can see shadows, but they're not as sharply outlined as they were. In fact, the sun in the from the stadium point of view, and they're about 6 miles away from the stadium now, it's clouded over, so it's just what they want.
Lisa Martin going back into the lead. Every time she goes in the lead, she seems to veer off the course. She's causing a little bit of... all she's got to do is keep following that blue line. She seems to have a little difficulty doing that. But I've noticed she's looking at her watch. She's got her own watch on. She'll have timed it. She's looking at it again, glancing at it there. 10 kilometres in 34 minutes and 16 seconds, which is significant slowing in the last 2 kilometres. Whilst they were initially running under world record pace, they're now slowed well outside of that and quite sensibly so. But you notice how keen they are to look along those benches and get their own drinks, because that's very, very important. Their drinks are tailor-made. They've got the kind of salts in them that they know how to suit their stomach and suit their insides, and that's pretty important.